Hi, I'm Rick Eads, and today we're going to be talking about the PCI Express demo at DesignCon. So overall, we're going to be showing a PCI Express Gen 7 demonstration. Now, that's pretty interesting, I think, because right now the specification for Gen 7 is only barely begun. We're only at the 0.5 revision level as of December of 2023. So being able to have a demonstration of the capabilities of Gen 7, which is 64 gigabaud or 128 gigabits per second, we think is pretty substantial, especially this early in the development process for the technology. So what we're doing in this particular demo is a physical layer presentation of transmit test and receive test. So we have our device from AlphaWave. We're using a UXR 110 gigahertz two-channel scope, and up on the screen you'll see an eye diagram from that. And then we use the new M8050 BERT to do a bit error ratio test, or a BER test, of the device. Now, since PCI Express from Gen 6 to Gen 7 utilizes forward error correction, the BER that we have to hit in order for the effect to be effective is one error in 10 to the 6 bits. And we're doing quite a bit better than that with the silicon that we have here. So that's a great sign that the industry is ready in its development of technology for PCI Express 7. And the even greater news, of course, is that Keysight has equipment that can be used today for pathfinding and for people who have plans to go forward with PCI Express 7.0. They are able to purchase equipment to do that development work today. With this particular demo, we've partnered up with a company called AlphaWave, and AlphaWave has provided us with their Zeus Core IP, which is shown in this test chip that's right down here at the bottom. Now, this is a 128 gigabit per second capable PHY. So we've set the demo up to do two important physical layer tests. One is transmit and one is receive. So on the transmit side, we're using a UXR 110 gigahertz oscilloscope. And in that scope, we have the ability to render an eye diagram. So we're not really applying a lot of equalization here, because you can see that across the top. But we're demonstrating that with some basic de-embedding of the breakout channel of the AlphaWave electrical evaluation board, we're able to get an open eye. And that's really significant, I think, at 64 gigabaud and 128 gigabits per second. And so we're making measurements for jitter, and the performance of the part is very much in line with what we expect at this point for the development of test chip silicon for PCI Express Gen 7. The second test that we're running in this demo for PCI Express Gen 7 is a bit error ratio measurement test, or a BERT test, or a BER test. So featured in this particular test is the M8050 bit error ratio tester from Keysight. This is a 120 gigabaud capable device or instrument. So you have basically two main functions on this BERT. You have here a pattern generator as well as an error detector. So the purpose of a BERT is to send out a signal with impairments, and we have this particular BERT has remote heads because of the high speed that it supports. So this is the remote head for the pattern generator, and then over on the other side we have another remote head for the error detector. And these remote heads allow us to get fairly close to the device that we're testing, because generally you want to try to keep the cable lengths as short as possible, so they have minimal effect. Now, we're sending out a PRBS31 from the generator, and this is going into an ISI channel board. Now, we have the ISI channel board to add ISI, or insertion loss based impairments, onto the signal that are going into the receiver of the device. So this particular device, operating at 64 gigabaud, has a Nyquist frequency of 32 gigahertz. So the loss of this board is approximately 25 dB. So it's pretty significant. That's 25 dB at Nyquist or at 32 gigahertz. So that's adding some impairment to the signal. That's going into the receiver. And then the device is in loopback. So that means that it's taking the BRBS31 from the BERT and then it's flipping it around and sending it out its transmitter. The BERT's job then is to compare what was sent with what is received. And so over on the user interface over here, you can see we're making an active BER measurement that demonstrates we're achieving a BER of roughly around 1 e to the minus 9, 1 e to the minus 10. Now that's really significant because the spec limit is 1 e to the minus 6. So we're a couple of orders of magnitude above what the spec limit is. And so again, given where the specification is for Gen 7, it's really nice to see that we have equipment as well as real silicon that we can use to demonstrate that the goals of the specification are going to easily be met by the state of the art of current capabilities in silicon and instrumentation. And the key message of all of this is that, you know, a couple of things. One, the specification probably won't be finished until 2025, maybe mid-2025 when we hit the 1.0 level for the base specification. But the key message is the industry has silicon that's capable of operating at 64 gigabaud today. But perhaps more importantly, from a Keysight perspective, if you're interested in supporting Gen 6, Gen 7 on your products, then we have equipment in the M8040 and especially the M8050 BERT for PCI Express Gen 7, as well as the 110 gigahertz UXR for making the physical layer measurements of the transmitter as well as the receiver. These products are available and shipping today.